Hello and welcome back. This is episode 18 of my vlog series about creating the art for a 2D video game. And this episode is basically going to be a continuation from last week. So if you watched last week's episode, you saw I started to make some of the assets that we need for like the ranching portion of our game. So I think I made the barn last week and some of the furnishings for the barn, like the stalls and the trough and the feeder and all of those things. And so this week is actually going to be a little bit more gameplay heavy. So I am going to show footage from of me drawing like the cows and some of the items that you need to take care of your cows. So, milk pail, brush, that sort of thing. And then after that, I'm going to show you some gameplay so you can actually see what it all looks like in game. So if you haven't watched last week's episode, I will try and remember to link that below because it's a good lead in to this week's episode. And then we're going to go ahead and switch over to my screen, and I am going to show you some of my drawing footage and then a little bit of gameplay. So I will be back in just a second. Okay, let's draw some cows. So as you can see already on the screen, I actually have a cow already done. That was sort of my first pass, basically, at doing a cow. But it doesn't, and I didn't remember to record it, but it doesn't really matter because in the end I end up changing him anyway. One of the things I really struggled with was figuring out how cute to make the cows. So I wanted to do them super cute, these super cute, chubby, lovable cows. But on the other hand, I feel like if you do these super adorable cows and you get like really emotionally attached to them, you're probably never going to want to like butcher them. And at least in our game, that is an option. In some other like farming simulator type games, the animals are not for killing. They are strictly for cows give you milk, sheep give you wool, etc., but you don't kill them. In our game, you do have the option to butcher animals if you want, and for some of the animals, that's really going to be their main purpose. So, for example, I've talked about our giant rats. They are actually done. I will show them another time, but the giant rats are essentially, things that breed really, really fast so that you can create cheap, quick food for your peasants, and they're really good, especially for players first starting out who don't exactly have, big thriving farms yet and just need to keep the peasants fed. Well, you can feed them rat meat. But the thing is if their main purpose is basically to be butchered, did I really want them to be super adorable and for you to get super emotionally attached to them? So I went back and forth on that quite a bit. Yeah, even with the cows, because with the cows, you can keep them, you can use them at, for milk, but what about all the bulls? So you need maybe one or two to keep breeding your cows, but you probably don't want a full barn full of bulls because they can't really do anything else other than, make more cows. And so eventually you're probably going to want to turn them into steaks. And so I went back and forth on this, and as you can see, I did make this cow a little bit chubbier, made a little bit rounder, a little bit fatter in the face, and just I made him cute, but hopefully not like so adorable your face melts off kind of cute, which I think was probably a pretty good compromise. And of course, we've already moved on, but you saw me create a calf there too. So there we have a cow, a bull, a pregnant cow, and with the huge fat body, like comically huge. I was debating how fat to make the cow, and I decided, go big or go home. The cow is going to be super, super uncomfortably fat. So I made a big pregnant body and then a calf. And actually, I'm not even sure we're going to end up using that pregnant body. We've come up with a very PG sort of way of making our cows and other animals reproduce, which I will show on a later video. So we may not even need that pregnant body, but it was fun to make anyway. So now, of course, beyond the animals, you have all of the extra stuff that comes with them. So I made like a milk bottle, which is, the item that you get after you milk the cows. And of course, I'm making the steak, which I will not be showing today, at least not be showing how you actually go about getting the steak. Again, much like the breeding, we've come up with a very GPG way of butchering your cows that is non-violent and kind of humorous. And so, of course, this will be the item you get when you do that. But there's also things like I'll be making the milk pail and let's see, a brush. I think I make that in this episode at some point so that you can take care of and love your cows. and a rope so that you can lead them around from one place to another. And the rope will come in handy later, actually. I'll show you how it works today. But it's really going to be used more for, well, things like butchering. When you need to lead your cow to the chopping block. It's not actually a chopping block. I promise it's really G-rated. But when you need to lead your cow there, well, you can use the rope to lasso them and to pull them along. So that's what that's going to be used for. And I also think I make, the other thing I make is a pitchfork and muck. I think I discussed muck in our last episode, but basically, I mean, cows poop. They do. And not just cows, but all the rest of your animals will as well. And if you don't stay on it, pretty soon your barn is going to be full of big, mushy piles of poop. And so that's what the pitchfork is for. You've got to clean it up. And actually, we're thinking of, other than just being, you know, a total pain and giving you something that you have to do to stay busy to keep your barn clean and keep your cows happy, I think we're going to give the muck another purpose. So after you clean it up, I've made a compost bin. It is done. It's not up and running, but it is done. And we thought, well, after your cows poop or your other animals, I keep saying cows, but this applies to all of the animals you'll be able to get. But you will be able to take that and put it in your compost bin and eventually maybe turn it into fertilizer so it can serve a purpose in the great circle of life. And of course, the last thing you're seeing me make there is the pitchfork. And actually, the pitchfork's a good example of how to be lazy slash efficient, because most of my tools that I've made have wooden handles. So the hammer has a wooden handle, the axe, I think the pickaxe does, and the pitchfork, I planned on having one too. So one of the best ways to do that is just to erase the head, in this case, the hammer head there off of my hammer tool, and just replace it with those pitchfork tines. And that saved me a whole lot of time. And so, you know, the longer I work on this game, the more little shortcuts I find, and they are super helpful. So that worked really well for me. And now that that's done, I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to the game, and so that you can actually see all of this stuff and see how it looks in action. Okay, here we are back in our kingdom, and it is raining today. I bet you weren't expecting that, were you? The last time I think I played, I think we still only had sunny weather, but we're starting to get a variety now. See, I finally get to make use of this little rainy weather tile that I made, you know, several episodes back. But here I want to show you, oh, and here come my peasants. They just got breakfast and they're heading to the fields to help me with all of these crops over here. Here they come. All right, I'm going to show you the barn, because that's what this episode is all about. So here I have a barn. And if you'll remember, I built that on the last episode, and this is pretty cool. You may also notice, if you have watched any of my other gameplay demos, that we have some new little icons. You know, I'm going to get rid of this little tree here because it is in my way. Ha! There we go. We have some new icons now that show you how you can interact with things. So before we were just using this, you might remember it was like a blue spinning circle for anything that you could interact with. But since there are different kinds of interactions, I made these little icons. So for storage, we have a cardboard box. So right here, you can store things in your barn. Right now I have hay stored in there for feeding the animals, but you could also put, you know, your tools in there as well. And right here, a blue circle is basically just a general interaction. And I can use that to open up the barn to let the cows out if I want. And of course the open door shows that I can open a door, so let's go on inside. Good morning, cows! Look how cute they are! So there, I've got two cows in here and a bull. And you saw there briefly, you saw those little thought bubbles come above their head, and it kind of shows you what the cows, what they need for the day, what their needs are. So I've got down here my brush, and looks like they all need milked. Oh, but our bull wants brush, so I'm gonna come over to him, and I'm gonna brush him. Here we go, and he loves it. It makes him happy. And meanwhile, our cow, so I'm gonna take out my bucket here and milk my cow. And as you can see, I've got another bottle of milk now here in my inventory. I'm gonna go milk my other cow. Here we go, makes her happy. Now you can see here too, if you remember last episode, here was that hay rack that I made, and as long as hay is stored in the barn, it'll automatically come here and the cows will be able to come and eat it. And over here, I know it's a bit dark, but if you look, here is muck. And so I'm going to use my pitchfork, and I stab at it until it breaks apart. There we go, now I can pick it up. Now I've got muck in my inventory. Oh, my cows want brushed. I better take care of that. There we go, now I have muck in my inventory. So the barn is nice and clean. And I'm going to go ahead and brush my cows. There we go, so they are happy. So the other thing that you can do is you can use this rope that I made to lead your animals around. So I'll just take it out here, we've got this coiled rope, and I can throw it around the neck of my cows, and I can lead them around, which is a lot of fun to do. Right now it doesn't serve any particular purpose except that, you know, like I said, it's fun to drag your cows around. But later, of course, when there are other things implemented where you will actually need to lead your animals to specific locations, that's what it will be for. Also, if I open up my menu here, you can assign your peasants to help you out with your animals. So for today, for the sake of demonstration, I pretty much took care of them myself. But if I wanted to, I could assign, you know, one of my peasants here to come, and she would help me with the brushing and the milking and whatnot. And down here on our menu, we've got a little icon for our animals, and this shows you each of the animals you own, their mood, and of course how much they love you. And right now my cows each love me one heart, which I will take since I've only had them for like a couple of days. So I hope you've enjoyed today's episode and will join me again next Friday, and until then I hope you have a wonderful week.